abiding place. Lord, you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. Lord, you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. You are my abiding place forever. But you are my abiding place. But you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. Lord, you are my abiding place. And I'm abiding, abiding in this love.
Communing, communing in this love.
Abiding, abiding in this love.
Communing, communing in this love.
Oh, I'm abiding, abiding in this love. but you are my abiding place forever. But you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. But you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. Lord, you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. Lord, you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. But you are my abiding place. You are my abiding place. You are my abiding place forever. And I'm abiding, abiding in this love.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, power in the name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Woo! All power, all authority in the name above every name, Jesus Christ the Lord, Jesus Emmanuel, the scepter of Judah, Shiloh's come. Star of David, Most High God, Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end, Lamb that was slain, King of kings, Savior, Redeemer, Great High Priest, Brother, friend, intercessor, Jesus, and I will dance before you. I will pray for friend. I will pray for you. I will pray. I'ma praise your name forever, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Lord. When you step into the room, when you step into the place, when your name is exalted, oh God, our hearts are lit on fire. Our feet are set to dance. Our lives so consecrated. When you step into the room,
when you walk into the room, everything changes. Darkness starts to tremble at the light that you bring. When you walk into the room, every heart starts burning. Nothing matters more than just to sit here at your feet and worship you. we worship you, Lord. We love you, Lord.
We love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without you, Jesus. We love you, and we can't get enough. All this is for you, Jesus. Jesus. When you walk into the room, sickness starts to vanish. Every hopeless situation ceases to exist. And when you walk into the room, the dead begin to rise. There is resurrection life in all you do. We love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without you, Jesus. We love you, and we can't get enough. Jesus, we love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without you, Jesus. We love you, and we can't get enough. Oh, this is for you, Jesus.
We love you, praise.
impartation. Who you are, yes you are. We love we can't get enough. Oh, this is for Jesus. We love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without Jesus. We love. And we can't get it now. All this is for you, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, my Jesus. Kalababa. Kalababa, shele.
When you walk into the room, everything changes. Darkness starts to tremble, the light that you bring. When you walk into the room, every heart starts burning. Nothing matters more than just sit here at your feet and worship you. Oh, worship you. Oh, worship the King of Glory. King of Glory. Hear our song, O God. Hear our song, O Lord.
Oh,
sick in their body tonight, struggling in your body, just wave at me. This is your verse.
When you walk into the room, sickness has to vanish. Every hopeless situation ceases to exist.
And when you walk into the room, you can begin to rise. There is resurrection life in all beauty. We love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without you.
Starts burning. Nothing matters more than just sit here at your feet and worship you. When you walk into the room, everything changes. Darkness starts to tremble at the light that you bring. When you walk into the room, every heart starts burning. Nothing matters more than just sit here at your feet and worship you. Come to worship you. Come to worship you. Come to worship you. We come to worship the King. Oh, oh.
lift your hands and speak the name of Jesus. Sing the name of Jesus over your body. Sing the name of Jesus over your life. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prune Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prune Him more and more. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Love you, Jesus. Lift my voice. Holy. Mama. La mamma menene ne mosse la bata. Oh, ne menene ne odisea. Cola basha. Cala mamma menene ne
su. Ta cura ma se che te ora ambrandere de essi plato sabana nepra. E che hanno mosse prandere de oh. For a thousand tongues to sing of my Redeemer's love. Ah, se to rimando alla bocco provo, ma breve si plato con Romaya. Father, but you've gone beyond all that and given to us the glory of your only begotten Son and filled us with the glory and the majesty of the Holy Spirit, that we may sing the high praises, that we may open up our mouth with the divine utterances that belong to the eternal ages, that you exist in forever and forever and forever and forever and forever and forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Joy, joy, joy.
That we will ever need. All that I need, I find in you, O Lord. Ha 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 ha. My Elios, then I'm a door, and I be a suicide, but I hope he's in an act of door. He can't keep an axis and a sassy proto. Mamma, she brave, mamma, man, no, he, and all who seek me, they shall find me. Those who call upon my name, they shall see the wonders that my hand has performed, and the word that's gone forth that I will establish, says the Lord. Open your heart, open the gates. Oh, let the King grow, enter in high. Open the gates, and the King of Glory shall come in. We open up our hearts, Lord. We open up the gates, so King of Glory come. Reveal through us, let your name be glorified. Woo! Ha! Come on, dear, she right. Let me be. She right, mama, on the same. I pray that the church will find a place of worshiping that cannot come to an end. I intercede that my people will sit at my feet. Watch the wonders that only I can do, says the Lord. Open your heart, open the gates to the Lord Most High. The King of Glory shall come in. 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 He'll be revealed to you. Southern California with sovereign moves of grace, sovereign moves of power, sovereign works of life. Open up the gates. Who is the King of Glory? Who is it, this King of Glory? Who is the King of Glory? The Lord God, mighty and strong, mighty in battle, mighty in word. Mighty and strong,
yes.
Mighty in battle, Lord God of hosts, the Lord God of armies, Jesus Christ the King. The Lord God of hosts. Hallelujah. Ha 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 ha. Ha! Shout to the Lord! Shout to the Lord! Shout to the Lord! Shout to the Lord. Shout to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
prescription for your cure.
Yeah.
God's prescription for your cure. Shout to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody on a catch on a bako, Sunday on a Sipaya Ropopo, Sipaya, come on.
Hallelujah!
Shout to the Lord,
mighty Lord. Hallelujah!
Mighty and strong, Lord God of battles. The Lord God of hosts, mighty and strong, mighty in battle, Lord God of armies. Listen, here's what we got to grab hold of. This awesome and wonderful thing that God has done in making us co-laborers together with Him. Of His husbandry and of His house. And if we'll be found laboring in those things which God has prescribed, which He has declared and which He's written, then when He comes with the sovereign movings as with the early and the latter rain, then we will be found working together with Him, in agreement with Him, having been prepared of Him, doing His works, His signs, His wonders, moving, so desperate about being moved by Him and moving with Him, that we will be the ones that can at that moment in time execute His sovereign will. What happens is our in seasons, as it were, of less than the great movings of God, people will begin to turn to their own solutions. They'll begin to prescribe for them their own distinct differences, what they think is going to make them successful, what they describe or believe the will of God to be, and they're found not laboring together with Him in that place where He prepares us unto every good work. Somebody said, how long is this going to take? Doesn't matter, we're going to be found waiting here, just enjoying the thing anyways. It doesn't matter, because the Lord, He says, I'll make you 10,000 times more. The Lord make you 10,000 times more. Just think about God taking us and making us each 10,000 times more, so reproducing what He's entrusted with us, that He can sweep the nations of the earth with His purpose and His with will. Because somebody's willing to stay with it. You know, I hear people talk about, try to give apologetics on why they disagree with the faith movement, as though we're trying to impose our will upon God. Give me a break. Somebody just discovered that God has purpose to speak through our mouth and act through our lives. And they begin to prophesy and declare it. This is how it shall be. They begin to decree the word of God. Have you ever noticed that when all these people start giving their apologetics, that the presence and manifest glory of God just nowhere to be found? It's when the heart begins to cry out in love and affection. God wants the kisses, you know. Yes. He does. And we're going to become experts at kisses. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father's been looking for somebody for the ages, as it were. And so He made it possible that anyone who would believe and anyone who would call upon the name, because the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to everyone, and God has excluded no one because He hates unjust balances and has appointed salvation for all men. He has desired it for everyone. He wills that all men be saved. People try to reason that out. Instead of just believing what's said, they're trying to think that they can crawl up inside of the mind of God and theoretically hypothesize how He did it and why He did it. Give me a break. Father doesn't want any of that mess. And every time you watch this go on, I mean, so many people are not here tonight. And so many people have come through this ministry and left because we did not fit in to the mold of what they believe God is supposed to do, because it was this. I can't find any fault here. I don't want to see Lakiposhama and Daikipana. I don't even want to leave here. Father's looking for you and I to start believing something that he describes as faith, always on the terms of such supernatural, miraculous things. He doesn't describe faith after the realms of what human effort can do, what man can function in. He always talks about it on a level like a little bit of it takes mountains and moves them into the sea. A little bit of it says redefines the course of nature. You sycamine tree, you be plucked up by the roots and planted over there in the sea and produce fruit there for me. This is amazing. God's realm of faith. It's what he wants us to grab a hold of. Hallelujah. He wants us to open up our mouth. Papa wants to show us some things tonight, you know. He wants to ask us some questions. Like, can these bones live? Here's Ezekiel looking at bones and they're totally dry. He's describing them. The physiological are scattered. They're scattered. There's not one laying side the other. They're dry. They're not even wet. I mean, they're so dead. They're double dead. They dry. They're deteriorating. They're crumbling, in effect. And God says, prophesy. Well, he could sovereignly have done it, but he said, I'm going to have myself a co-laborer with me who's going to be willing to hear my voice and listen to my questions and give me some correct answers, who's going to be willing to respond to what I tell him to do, even though it goes beyond all the realms of anything that could possibly reasonably be concluded as sensible. And absolutely impossible. But to those who will agree with God, because that's the first and foremost principle of faith, it is amen to agree. That's what, and Abraham amen to Father. Abraham amen to Father. He said amen to God, and God counted it to him for righteousness. He counted it to him for righteousness because he agreed with God. The foundation of faith is to agree with God. And then trust him that the things that he said that he would do, he will most certainly bring them to pass. And if Father so determines to allow you and I to go through all kinds of situations and hindrances and things that make it seem that much more impossible for it to come to pass, so what? Stand there and prophesy. Worship. Somebody asked me, said, tell me, what's the solution to my problem? I always, most of the time, got the same answer. You need to worship more. You don't dance enough. No. You get up in the morning. You get up in the morning. You start dancing. The first thing that happens is you start laughing at yourself. You and your wife's going at it. You know, I believe in just imitating those who follow Jesus. When I first heard that Wigglesworth got up in the morning, because I just like looked at Wigglesworth's life and said, oh, Lord, I want that. But more. And then I discovered, you just start investigating someone's life. I found out they got up in the morning and danced around. So I said, okay, that's what I'm going to do. Hallelujah. I'm going to dance around. Hallelujah. When doubt tries to assail me, I lift up the high praises. I have a sharp two-edged sword in my hand and the high praises of God in my mouth, and thereby I steal the enemy. Thereby I stop all doubt. I cast down everything, every imagination, every logic of men, every rational thinking of a human realm, every limitation that belongs to man. And I stand there and praise God that he is trustworthy, that what he has spoken he shall surely bring to pass, that he formed his word in me to reveal his word through me.
Hallelujah.
About to run around.
You know, there's people who think that that's excessive emotion. Well, let me just tell you right now, when you've got rivers of divine emotion coming up out of you, that's not excessive. That's like not even hardly, that's just that's starting to act like you're alive now. That's moving around. It is a word. It is. And you know, it's just amazing to me. It is amazing to me. But I know without any question in my heart that those who seek the Lord and who are willing to learn a characteristic of Father that is so essential. You know, when God revealed himself, he said that he's full of goodness and full of truth. Really, the particular word, Hebrew word, that is used there is actually faithfulness. Yes, he's full of truth, but he's faithful. And something he wants to show to us and prove to us is one of the fundamental, primary characteristics of who he is. He's faithful. And there's some things that the Lord's, he says, I'm going to do this for you. And he wrote it in his word, which is forever settled in heaven, that he watches over to hasten to bring to pass. And then it seems like that, you know, you're just rejoicing and shouting about it, worshiping God. And then all of a sudden it seemed like that, you know, there was a delay. Huh? You expected it to happen tomorrow. When I came to San Diego, I had so many men of God saying all the great things that would happen in Southern California that God would do through us. It's been 32 years later. No, forgive me. That's how long Ann and I are partners in this. That's how long we've been married. It's really more like 36 years later. We had some amazing moments. When we had 6,000 people all together screaming and hollering in Seal Beach, to having great things happen here in San Diego, where, you know, we went for 4 years, almost 5 years, with continuous meetings. God gave us just so much real estate down there. And I mean, God's done great things, but it's nothing compared to what he's declared, what he's spoken, what he's purposed, which is not just a word of prophecy, because there's already something that goes far beyond that, that precedes that, that's much bigger than that, that's more certain word of prophecy. It's already what he's decreed and declared in his word will be in our lives, because we agree with him. Because we have learned faithfulness. Just like he's faithful, he wants to teach us how to be faithful. Just like he's full of love, he wants to teach us to walk in love and joy and peace and all the characteristics of his own divine nature. What a privilege that we get to learn this, that we get to do this, that we get to participate in. It's no problem to give all diligence to making our calling and election sure when we recognize that it's learning his majesty and splendor and glory, his life forevermore. It's not some kind of a works program where we earn favor with him. It's our privilege to now be taught of God the Holy Ghost how to walk in the splendor of the ages, you know. Amazing. How we've got it all wrong. It's come from a negative perspective over and again. Oh, we're going to have to understand what Father has given us the opportunity to do. You know, and I had many times in my life, and I know that the Lord does this with you, and he's doing this with you right now. In the midst of this wait, in the midst of this season, as it were, the Lord looks at us and goes, how do you feel about me now? Do you still like the relationship? Do you still believe that I am who I am, who I say that I am? You know, I like to translate I am that I am. I like to translate it this way because it literally means this. It's like God shows up to Moses and goes, it's really me. It's really me. That's really what I am. That I am literally means it is really me. When they said, where, you know, when in the garden and they were addressing Jesus because they come to find Jesus, they're asking, where is he? He goes, it's me. It's me. I know we like to theologically say, I am. But it's me. He's saying, it's me. I've come to reveal myself to you. Hey, it's me. It's God still walking in the midst of the garden saying, Adam, where are you? It's me. I'm here to walk with you. I'm here to do all those things I said I would do. I believe with all of my heart that our biggest challenge is learning how not to trust in our own personal arm of flesh. We've tipped the scale to where that it's just way too much on us. No. Father wants us to stand still in the midst of his will and behold his salvation. Hallelujah. People, if you'll learn how to praise and you'll learn how to worship, you'll have the greatest advantage in dealing with everything that tries to assail our thoughts and our lives and make ineffective the faith that God has given us. Faith is his divine ability imparted to us to do his supernatural works. His divine ability imparted to you and me to do his supernatural works. And it begins on the simplest childlike manner. I'm going to agree with you. Moving mountains, I agree. Whatever I say, you're going to do it. I agree. Blind eyes, deaf ears, great Holy Ghost conviction sweeping the hearts of men. Manifest presence of God so powerful it goes to a whole nother dimension of reality of who the one and living God is. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. He truly is holy, holy, holy. That'll pull me right away right there, I'm going to tell you right now. You can't do anything when somebody's moving in holy, 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 you know. Oh, Rabbah, Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. People tonight, I want everybody in this place to be so absolutely encouraged. Understand, my mama told me about the three preacher killers, but she didn't tell me about the big one. She told me about money, and she told me about pride, and she told me about, you know, immorality. But she didn't tell me about the big one. I discovered the big one. And I began to understand this thing that Satan does to stop the move of God in our life. And I decided one day that I wasn't going to hide behind the rocks and in dens anymore. I wasn't going to take the chicken trail home because a garrison of Philistines blocked the king's highway. I said, you discouragement, you power of discouragement, you power that threatens the work of God in my life, I come not with sword nor shield, but in the mighty name of God. This day I shall take your head, and I shall give your body to the beast of the field and to the fowls of the air. Ha ha. And I'm going to stand over here, and I'm going to praise God for who he is. I'm going to praise God for what he's done. I don't need nothing else. I don't want anything else. I have no other desire. Do your work in me. Let your fire burn in me. Let your potter's hand shape me. I have no other desire but thee. No other desire but thee. I had a great moment of crisis in my life in the year 2000. We had Brother Evangelist Carlos Anacondia in our field that we had, 10-acre field, and we had a platform, my goodness, was huge. That platform was massive. God blessed us with so much great equipment, and we had them for 10 days, and so it overlapped a Sunday, and I did not want to all the people in the invited place to go to work, take out the equipment, put it back over into the church building, but I knew, I had a suspicion, that on Sunday morning, because Carlos was going to be ministering Sunday night, that on Sunday morning, there probably wouldn't be enough people, because there's 5,000 chairs out there, there probably wouldn't be enough people to fill the front row. And when I got to the meeting, my expectation was a little high. The front row really was not even being threatened. I went over. At that time, I always played the guitar or the flute or something. I went over, sit down. Lord, why must you humble me this way? Why? Why? Why must I go through this? And I was sitting there sulking about the whole thing. And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and said, why are you doing this? I said, I'm doing this for you, Lord. And I just busted. I broke. And I got so filled. The potter's hand shaped me, and the fire of God burned in me. so that once again I could stand and say, I have one desire. All others pale in comparison. It does not even register anymore. I mean, I tell you, I preached that morning like I was preaching to the 40, 50,000 people that ultimately within 3 years the Lord had me preaching to. Just think of it. I'll tell you what, I promise you. I promise you. It's a good thing that you're going through. I promise you. It's a good thing. Because what Papa's preparing us to do, I mean, 10,000 years from now, we'll talk about it. What Papa's preparing us to do and ruling and reigning with Him and walking in the fullness of His majesty and glory, to see Him as He is, for we shall be like Him. Oh, there's nothing in this life that can compare to the glory that's about to be revealed in you and me. There's nothing, I promise you, there's nothing in this world that should ever hold power to sway us, to change our perspective. I'm going to keep praising. You know, my wife hears me and say this all the time. Anytime we're threatened, anytime something tries to come and touch my emotions, which are a sacred, virtuous place that only belongs to God, I just simply say, let's watch what God will do. Let's just stand and watch what God will do. Somebody said, oh, you know, you cannot make it to the morning. By the evening, you're going to be dead. Let's watch what God will do. Let's praise Him a while. Let's just worship. Let's just stir up the joy. Let's just stir up the confidence. Let's just stir up the boldness. Let's just stir up the assurance. I believe with all of my heart that boldness, confidence, and assurance are three of the fruits of the Spirit that are so important to Papa. So important. He said, I want you to look at the man who has some visitors come over, and he doesn't have any food to set before him. Watch how he acts. He's going to go bang on the door till somebody gets up. He said, this is how I want you to act. I want you to have this kind of boldness. I want you to have this kind of confidence. And he says it over and over and over. If I took the time tonight, we'd be here till past midnight talking about over and over again how Father develops within His people's life boldness, confidence, an assurance. And it's been left out of the fruits of the Spirit. Listen, praise God for the nine fruits of the Spirit, that are named in Galatians. But I promise you, there's much, much more. There's much, much more. And I promise you tonight that if you'll begin to take a hold of these things and these principles of faith, you begin to grab a hold of the reality of what God wants to establish within us, the behavior, the actions, the reactions to Him, to the things that we encounter, then out of this agreement with Him, out of this trusting Him, out of this place of worship and praise, faith will be so developed, so strengthened in our life, so increased within us, that all these exploits, Papa's always taking it big, always taking it big, these works and greater works.
Right.
And He had to tell us that. You know, He had to tell us that because we would have never been bold enough to ask Him for greater works.
Right.
We would have never had the insight that Elisha got walking around Elijah, because he suddenly discovered, I believe Elisha discovered, that Elijah functioned in something that did not belong to him or to anything in the realms of humanity. And so that's why he said, I want double what you got. Because nobody can give you double what they got. He was directing his attention to the Almighty God. Where is the Lord God of Elijah?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It's about time to we say, if I be a man of God, it's about time that we say it in the context that we know what's about to happen. If I be a man of God, you watch what's going to happen next. You watch what's going to happen next. God is a man of battle. He is a man of war. He's a man of He is the God of armies. And He's taught you and I, and He's teaching you and me how to move with Him so that a bow of steel is broken with our arm, teaching our fingers to war, to take on everything that opposes the will and purposes of God, to take on everything that would try to diminish what Jesus purchased for us at Calvary, the authority that he gave to us when we were buried with him by baptism into his death, raised up to him with him in his resurrection, and now living together with him and seated together, that we are the living proof that he is seated at the right hand of the majesty on high, crowned King of kings and Lord of lords, executing his will on the earth. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, God will make you 10,000 times more. Look at me. You look in my eyes right now. God make you 10,000 times more than you are. God make you 10,000 times more than you are. God make you 10,000 times more than you are. God make you 10,000 times more than you are. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, those that are watching by the web, I say to you, God make you 10,000 times more than you are. I promise you, this is what Father is devoted to do. Agree with him. Trust him. You're never going to learn to trust anyone until you go through a crisis.
Yeah.
You don't really even know it. God gives us a vision that scares us to death, and it's impossible for us to produce. And if it takes a while for you to realize that and come to a conscious awareness of it, then that's the way it's got to be. If it says suddenly, you got to say, God, this is so much bigger than anything I can do. And I'm when you begin to behold that, one of the first instincts of man is to throw his hands up in the air and give up. But that's where we step in to a whole nother dimension and realm of cooperation with reality. My soul demands reality. My soul demands reality. My God is real, so real to me. My soul demands reality. My God is real. And believe me, if you haven't gotten it yet, there are many things that are continually coming out against us. And the more you'll allow God to strengthen you, fill you, the more you'll give yourself over to being a vessel of honor, consecrated to his will, the more the enemy is going to come out against you. But at the same time, Father has given you the strength and the ability to stand against it. And I promise you, there's so much of the Word of God that only becomes relevant when you need it. It only becomes relevant when you're in the big midst of it. Hallelujah. You cannot change a generation until you change the culture. And that ain't easy. That's going against everything that everybody believes. That's going against everything that everybody accepts. But praise God, we look over to history and time, and those are the people that we praise God. We're willing to obey him. Those are the people that we honor. Anyone easy for anyone?
No.
It is a wonderful thing to be in the fight. And I'll tell you right now, come on, people. You do not want a nosebleed section.
No.
Hallelujah.
Front
when the saints are gathered around the throne. If there's any time, I want to be on the front row. If there's any time, I don't want the honor of men. I want the honor of God. I can tell you, no man could ever give me a front row seat ever again in my life. And I'll be happy so long as I get one in the kingdom of God. So long as Baba gives it, I'm seeking the honor which comes from the Lord and him alone. Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Come on now.
Hallelujah.
It changes the dynamics of everything that you encounter, of every situation that you go through. Father is just looking for a place. We're not trying to impose our will on him.
Come on.
It's about time we start getting real and submitting to his will. Everybody who says those nonsensical things, they know nothing about this realm of his love and of his glory on the scale of supernatural exploits and doing the works in the ministry of Jesus, of seeing the move of God that comes through a people who are willing to be broken, who are willing to be humbled under the mighty hand of God. If you go into my office, you'll always see I love lowly beginnings. There's a picture of Pop Seymour at the beginning. He was a one-eyed black man who had to sit on the porch. He heard about these guys down in Kansas, in Topeka. They're talking about the move of God and believing God for great things. This outpouring of the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire. Well, they wouldn't let him come in because of segregation. He had to sit on a little three-step porch. They cracked the door. They were willing to crack the door so he could listen. It didn't bother him. Come on, think about it. I got a picture of John G. Lake when he still had a little tent that maybe could seat 50 people if you just crammed everybody in it. Hallelujah. Why are you doing this? For you, Lord. For you. Just for you. Well, then if he's my audience, if I have Father, Christ Jesus, and the Holy Ghost on the front row, and they're my audience, and they're enjoying the meeting. Hallelujah. Come on, people. This is for you as well, no matter where you're at in ministry, no matter what God's doing with you. Because this is the reality. You be faithful in what Father has given to you to do, and I promise you, promotion comes from him. Listen, his eyes go to and fro. The labors are still few. It's the place of shortage in the kingdom of God. His eyes go to and fro looking for someone, and he's not picky. The criteria is that you've got to agree that he's trustworthy, that he's going to do what he said he's going to do, that he called you, that he ordained you, that he chose you, that he elected you, that he placed you right in this wonderful predestinated plan to in every way be conformed to the image. Somebody said, How do I get conformed to the image? You start listening to the ministry of the Spirit, which is going to minister to you righteousness and not condemnation. And you go look in the mirror and you behold the very image of the living God. And there you are going to explode with boldness and confidence and assurance. From glory to glory. Those are dimensions. That's dimensions. Okay. That's dimensions. Praise God. Hutakaya. Listen, I want you to do something. We minister. We'll go strong on ministering, on giving, and hooking up with the miracle faith that God has placed within the realm of obedience in giving. And then we just call you guys to do it. And usually towards the end of the meeting. I always like the end of the meeting because the anointing is stronger. It always builds. The more you stay with the drink, it gets hukata mashaya. So people always give more at the end. I promise you. People have not learned the secret. They try to get the offering at the beginning. They need to wait to the end. They wait because the people who leave early don't give anyways. They just don't count. You're really getting a head count of the people that are really in. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Tonight, I want you to get an offering ready for Joe and Becky. They're getting ready to go to Hawaii and to Thailand, to the Philippines, which is really Asia. Philippines and Thailand, Asia. And we just want to be a part of the ministry. You know, there's people that God will, listen, I'm going to tell you right now, everybody's got to serve in their anointing. Listen to me, everybody's got to serve in the realms of their anointing. There's people that God give the ability to do both ministry and business to. I was sitting with Oral Roberts one day, and he was telling me all of his friends were doing various different ventures in business, and every time he stepped out to do a venture in business, it went belly up. There are some people that God has placed an anointing on to just serve him. Just to minister to him. And don't you forget it. Hallelujah. Hakataranayasha. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Papa pays good wages. Good wages. Good wages. Good wages. Riches untold. Hallelujah. 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 Riches untold. You got to sing that tonight sometime. So you just get that up, Shibramatiasmakuma, Recipa. You just get on my gatast. Get your mosilia. Get your zibrini. Get your offering ready so that you can bless the ministers of the Lord. You know, I love this. You read the first epistle of John and you'll be challenged more by the first epistle of John than you will be challenged by any epistle in the New Testament. And then he brings us to the third epistle and he talks to Gaius and to those that are with him. And he says, you guys are real. You guys got the real thing. It's just powerful, you know, because he's done laid it out. Who's got the real thing and who doesn't have the real thing. And he says, you guys are real. You guys give yourself to supporting those who are in the ministry. Think about that. They worked and labored for one purpose. Their whole anointing, as it were, their whole ministry was to work and labor to support those who God had anointed to go. Isn't that radical? Just think about it. Just spend some time with the third epistle of John. Just look at what he says to Gaius and to those that are with him. Hallelujah. And those are the people, you know, everybody wants to claim the promises that are given to the context, you know, of something that they're not in many times. You know, that was the context was, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. He's talking to a bunch of people who live to support the ministry. Hold up here. My God shall supply all that you have need of according to his riches and glory. He's talking to a bunch of people that impoverish themselves to take care of the ministers and the work of the ministry. Everybody wants to lay hold on that, but wait a minute. We're going to have to meet the conditions and be a part, you know, of the criteria that God has set here. Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on. You look at Abraham, his whole life, his whole focus of his life, he lived as a Bedouin, seek because he wanted everybody to see that he's seeking a kingdom whose builder and maker is God. And in that context, there's wealth and riches and honor and favor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But some, Papa set some people apart just to stand and sing praises and minister in his house and not to be distracted with anything else. Hallelujah. And he's going to take really good care of them. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Papa take better care of his people than man could ever take care of men or men could ever take care of themselves. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Papa wants you to have boldness. He wants you to have confidence. He wants you to have assurance. He wants you to have shameless boldness before him. Hallelujah. You know, and of course, you know, and I was referring to Luke chapter 11. When you get to Luke chapter 18, this is why men ought to pray and not to faint. And he talks about the widow. And then he says, ask a question. With this kind of persistence, will the Son of Man find this kind of faith when he comes? Will the Son of Man find these kind of people who know their God, who lay hold on him, who recognize that he is faithful, that he is going to speedily avenge his upright ones? Amen. He's going to speedily take up my cause. Your cause. And I, you know, it's a real pop quiz. Anybody know how to steal the Avenger? In this place tonight, does anybody know how to steal the Avenger? Does anybody know how to steal doubt and unbelief and discouragement? Anyone? I have a sharp two-edged sword in my hand. It's called the Word of God. And the high praise is in my mouth. And all my praises come right out of his word. And thereby. So everybody stand with me so you can get at your offerings. Wave them to the Lord. Just do a wave offering tonight. Huh? We do a wave offering to that which belongs to the Levites. Are you with me? It's true. Somebody said, you're talking Old Testament. Well, there's a spiritual application. And then it really exists. God's got his people. He's got his families. And he's got his consecrates. Hallelujah. And we get to be a part of that. So come worship the Lord with it.
Hallelujah. Alala mundi alesso per la banda. Demonia sonda meledeo. Cui la mosile non mi andando dove. All this is for you, Jesus. We love you. We'll never stop. love can't live without you, Jesus. We love you, and we can't get enough. All this is for you, Jesus. We love you. We'll never stop. Can't live without you. We love and we can't get enough. All this is for you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I tell you a funny story? My dad, when he was ministering in Corpus, you can sit down just for a minute. Y'all been standing all night, worshiping. You guys are amazing. Y'all have more stamina than any church I know of anywhere. I mean, they'll stand with you, but they're holding on to the back of the pew, and they're wobbling like they're about to die, but not you. It's like, how long can we go? Just dare us. Just. And my dad was ministering there at Corpus. He had this Jewish rabbi. He came and I don't know if they were doing a Feast of Tabernacles or something at the church, and they were just sharing some of the things. And you have to know my dad. He's 86 and he'll tell you anything. I mean, he'll just mouth off, you know, I was a jet fighter pilot. Like, where'd that come from and what's that got to do with it, you know? But he says, you know, we're Black Dutch. And he said, we're Black Dutch. So our name, Cruz, C-R-U-S-E. And the Jewish rabbi said, how do you know? He said, because we came from the Netherlands, and he said, most of the people, the Dutch, are blonde with blue eyes. And he said, but we're not. We have black hair and blue eyes. And that Jewish rabbi stopped him. He said, no, that's not why you're Black Dutch. This is crazy. He said, no. He said, you know why they called them Black Dutch? It's because they were the Jews that had come to the Netherlands. And he said, 99% of those had come from the tribe of Levi. They were Levites. They were Levites. So it's not by chance that I carry a Levitical mantle. You see, we thought that our heritage was black hair and blue eyes. But really and truly, my ancestors were just transplanted from Israel. It's not by chance that I carry a Levitical anointing, because it's a part of my DNA. Now, I have to step in to my purpose, and I have to step into my calling. But you see, God knew before I was ever formed in my mother's womb that He would raise us up as a voice in the land concerning worship. And that's what He's done. And I can't get away from it. You see, when I was a young man, when I was, I don't know, 9 or 10, I had asthma. And my dad, whenever we would ride in the car there in West Texas, we didn't have but 3 channels, so we didn't watch TV. But after he would minister on Sunday night, for him to decompress, he would get in the car and he would drive down the dirt roads of Odessa, Midland, and Monahans, and we would count the old derricks out in the field. Or we would count the coyotes as they would cross the highway between where we drove to and back home, and the jackrabbits on the side. It was his way of decompressing, but then they would sing. They would begin to worship and sing.
And so as a young man, I began to learn how to harmonize. And there was a man who came to Odessa, Texas when I was 9 years of age. His name was George Peck, and he was the artist in residence at, which is now the University of Texas at the Permian Basin. Back then was Odessa College. And he was the overseer of the boys choir in Arizona, Arizona State Boys Choir, which was like the Vienna Boys Choir of the West. And when he came, someone said, you need to get Joe to go down there and be a part of that choir. And so my dad took me once a week down to the university there to be a part of a 200 voice boys choir. And he began to put that heart of worship within me, and that heart to sing. Whenever the Odessa College would do an event like the Wizard of Oz or something like that, they used all of the boys choir as the munchkins. I know that's stupid, but you have to understand, God is preparing me for what he's called me to do. Then I go to East Texas, where my dad pastored. And I go to 10th grade. And when I get to the 10th grade, my instructor was Mike Templeton, who, at the end of my junior year, he went to the university, Texas A&M University, as the chancellor and the overseer of their choral department. And he was my choral director for 2.5 years in high school. Taught me how to read, taught me how to vocalize and how to breathe. Now, I was struggling with asthma this whole time. But then age 18, Dad says God's called us into full-time ministry. So with that background, as the oldest of our kids, then I was able to help my brothers and sisters, to help them in the way they were to breathe and to stand and project and all that, because I'd been taught that since age 9. But at age 18, I still struggled with asthma. And I went to a Baptist church in A-Leaf, Texas. And a Baptist pastor that had been filled with the Holy Ghost said, "This asthma is a hindrance to the call of God on your son's life." He said, "Do you mind if I lay hands on him and pray for him?" I was under an oxygen tent at the time, one of the very few times I could not breathe and sing. Just a sheet, Vicks, steam, filled with every kind of medication you could imagine to open my lungs. That pastor simply came and anointed my head with oil, and he said, "Father, we break this curse off of Joe's life." I didn't feel anything at the time, but when I woke up the next morning, my lungs were totally clear. And I've never had another asthma attack since. We received the baptism of the Holy Spirit in 1985. 1986, the ministry as we knew it, as our family, the Cruse family, basically the Lord shut every door, because our primary outlet for ministry was the music industry and the Baptist church. And once we received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the Baptists didn't want us anymore. We messed up their little program. We went and did Dallas Theological Seminary. We were to do one of their official events and chapels. And the word had gotten out that we had all received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So when our buses pull up there to unload, the president of the university met me at the door. And he said, "Son, I know we have you booked for this date." But he said, "Ain't gonna be none of that hand raising." He said, "None of that talking in tongues." He said, "You do your concert and you leave." I said, "Yes, sir. Whatever you want us to do." Back then, we carried a Yamaha electric grand piano. Remember, they were in two pieces. You hooked them and you rolled it, faced them, clamped them together, had hammers, strings, and the whole thing. There was a tuner, a piano tuner, waiting for us to get there so he could tune that piano every time we played Yamaha electric grand piano. Everything we had was totally electronic. So we had to have power, lighting, everything, electric guitars, everything was electric.
microphones, everything. We're there in their chapel, seats 22 to 2,500 people. We're in the middle of the second song, big, high, you know, celebration, dancing song, clapping your hands, and the power went out. And I turned around, and when I did, I saw all of a sudden the two lights come up on the back there, the battery-powered lights, just to put a little glow across the room. Lights were shining in through the stained glass windows, and all the students were standing around looking like, okay, now what? And I just stepped up to the front of the auditorium, to the edge of the stage, didn't lift my hands, laid down my microphone, and I just started singing, Alleluia. Alleluia. And it was amazing, because the glory of God rolled in that room. I didn't have to lift my hands, because every student and every teacher lifted theirs. And I didn't have to invite young people to the altar. They began to stream to the altar. And they fell on their face. They began to cry out. I mean, it was like this sound of heaven. You can't imagine, because you've experienced it. But that was the first time in my life that I knew that it was bigger than me. Because up to that point, we had been taught how to enter the stage. We had been taught how to bow and exit the stage. And we knew how long to stand on the side and count to three while they're still clapping, and make our entrance back on and wave to get another standing ovation. We'd been taught how to perform. But in that one moment, God showed me that it was bigger than me. That he wanted to do something, that if we would allow him to do something deep on the inside, that it would be something we could never contain and we could never take credit for. You see, you can't take credit for what he does. He told me, he said, son, you just create an atmosphere. You just create an atmosphere for me to work. And so my choice, it wasn't long after that to where Pastor Becky and I went to Dallas, Texas, and to Rockwall, Texas, and we were there for 4 years when Pastor Rodney came to our church, spent 6 weeks. God allowed us to travel and be a part of those incredible crusades. But here's the thing that ministers the most to me, Pastor Mark, and that is that when we were in Germany with Brother Reinhard Bonnke, I asked him to lay hands on me because I wanted that anointing for souls. When God allowed us to go to Brother Lester Summerall's there in South Bend and do revival meetings there at that great church, I asked Brother Lester to lay hands on me because I wanted that anointing that he had to teach and to preach. Pastor Rodney had Brother Dick Mills at the church. And Brother Rodney said, Joe, come here. Pastor Becky and I stepped out, and Brother Dick Mills began to prophesy. I had him lay hands on me because I wanted that prophetic gift in my life. Brother R.W. Shambaugh, every one of these great men, Miss Joyce Meyer, all of these great men and women of God, when I get around them, I say, would you please lay hands on me? Because I want to be a carrier of the anointing that you walk in. I know it's not just the laying on of the hands, but there is a transference of anointing. And what I'm saying is, I come into agreement. I speak amen. Talking about our Father God, the work of the Lord in our life, the work of Jesus in our life. What we're saying is amen. I come into agreement. I come into agreement with what you're doing, and I want to be a part. How can I walk in what you're asking me to walk in? Only way is total agreement. How can a husband and wife walk together except they come into agreement? We were talking this afternoon. I can't just do what I do because half of me is missing. I can't play. My wife can sing. But our ministry is very unique because it takes the two of us to do what God's called us to do. And what I felt in my heart tonight was for you to have an impartation of what it is to be a worshiper. I'm not saying you don't worship. I'm not saying that. You're probably the most worshiping church I've ever met in my life. The most spontaneous. No, I'm serious. Churches say they want to know how to flow. You know why they don't know how to flow? It's because they don't take time to learn how to flow. They don't practice what they say they want. This is a church that practices the spontaneity of the Holy Spirit and the flow of the Holy Spirit and the power of God working fresh in every meeting because you make room for Him. And I just felt tonight that we should just lay hands on people, minister to people. If you received half of what this man spoke, you've got enough to chew on for a month. Just in what he prophetically shared with all of us tonight. And I just heard the Lord say, it's time to receive. It's time to take hold of the things that he spoke of tonight. In the realm of the Spirit, walking away from the arm of the flesh, but truly taking hold of those divine things that God has promised all of us. He spoke to me tonight. He spoke to me tonight. You see, I know these things, but our natural mind is always fighting with the things of God. At least mine is. Because in this natural realm, we always divert back to the realm of the flesh. That's just the way our natural mind thinks. Well, Lord, what am I going to do? What if Becky, anyway, I already told her, I said, I'm going first. I'm telling you right now, I'm going first. And then she said, no, we're not, we're going together. I said, okay, I'll agree with that. I just don't know what I would do if my partner was not there. She said, you can sing to my CDs. I said, but I can't sleep with your CDs. I just felt in my heart tonight that it's time for us to receive. Maybe you had hands laid on you this morning. But I just believe that there is a fresh impartation that the Holy Spirit wants to bring to each and every one of us. My brother, right behind this sweet lady, that man with his hand on his face, come here. Come here. Come here. Just come and lift your hands. Now here's what I need you to do. I need some of you guys to help us so that we can make room to pray for people. I know if you all just come all at once and y'all stand behind each other, then I'm going to expect you to catch the person in front of you. Is that all right? Then I'll pray for you next. But I just believe with all of my heart The Lord wants to bring a fresh impartation. Sweet lady back over here, come. You, right there, come. Yes. The anointing of the Lord is on you right now. Just step out of your seat. Come and meet these that are standing here. Come and join them. Come and join them. Hallelujah. Fresh fire. Fresh fire. More. Jesus. Fresh fire. Fresh fire. Rabba Shelemaronde. Kalama Sembros de K. Rides de Manala. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Fresh, fresh fire, fresh fire of the Holy Ghost. Fresh fire,
fresh fire,
fresh oil. He's pouring tonight. The Lord is pouring fresh oil from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Fresh oil. Draw. Draw from that well of living water. He is a well of living water. It never runs dry. He never runs dry. He never runs dry. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus. More, 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 more. More. Fresh oil, fresh oil. And don't be in a hurry to get up. Don't be in a hurry. 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 Jesus. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Fresh.
Fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Jesus.
Fire the Holy Ghost. Fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Fire the Holy Ghost. He's pouring out oil. Fresh fire. Holy Ghost.
New levels.
New levels. Hallelujah. You're going to touch your next, you're going to touch your generation. God, use him to touch his friends. Thank you, Father. Choice, take
fresh fire, the Holy Ghost. Lord, 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 Jesus. Fire, there it is. Fire, Lord, Jesus.
Touch your people once again. Touch your people once again. Touch him, Lord, touch him. Such as I have. Give I thee, such as I have, give I thee, such as I have, give I thee, such as I have, give I thee, choice, fresh oil, fresh oil, such as I have, give I thee,
Jesus, fire. Jesus, Lord,
fresh oil. Fresh oil. Such as I have, give I thee. Such as I have, give I thee. Such as I have, give I thee. Jesus. 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 Whew. Don't be in a hurry. Don't be in a hurry. God's operating table. Don't be in a hurry. Fire the Holy Ghost. Fire the Holy Ghost. Fire the Holy Ghost. Fresh fire. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Fresh oil. Jesus. Jesus. Fresh oil. Fire. More. 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 Jesus. Jesus. Woo! More. More. More.
Fill.
Twice the anointing you've ever known. 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 Rama Celeronde. Reba Celerie. Yeah. Fire.
Ora si deve essere la bagna siano 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 ma le saite ora siano siano ora siano 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 ma saite
Fresh fire. Fresh fire. Holy Ghost. Kalamaroste. Burn. Burn. Fresh fire. Holy Ghost.
Fire.
Time to receive. It's time to receive. It's time to drink. Drink. Drink from the well that never runs dry. Drink from the well that never runs dry. Drink from the well. Oh, hallelujah. There is a well. Never shall run dry. He's everything you need. Come on, it's a journey. Let him fill you up tonight. Fresh oil. Just like our car needs fresh oil. Tonight he comes. He pours in the oil and the wine. Fresh oil. From heaven. Drink. Fresh. Jesus. Such as I have, give I thee. Such as I have, give I thee. Kalama selamonondo. Ola mabashelamenana marande. A new song. You may say, I don't sing. I don't write songs. Yes, you will. Songs of the Holy Ghost.
New songs of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah. Come on, drink. Drink. Fresh. Whew. Twice the anointing your dad has ever walked in. Twice the anointing I've ever known. Carriers of the glory of God. A carrier of the glory of God. Twice the anointing your folks has ever walked in. Shola barret. Kalama selabaronde. Your deepest desires. The secret dreams. I see them being made manifest. Even this year. Even this year. Rama Salabaronde. Kalama Sadabende. Ustemende. Rama Salamaronde. Fresh oil. Fresh oil. Fresh fire, the Holy Ghost. Woo! Fresh. Fresh oil. Jesus. 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 Fresh fire, the Holy Ghost. Kalama Rostaka. Streams of income. Wisdom. Fresh fire. New ways of thinking. Roma Salabarondaria. Touch your Lord. Touch her. Let your fire fall. Use your Lord to touch her generation. Jesus. 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 Kalababa Shelebere de Moronde. Use her, Lord. Use her. Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Shola Maneste, wisdom way beyond your years. Fresh fire, twice the anointing you've ever known. Kolabasta Mondaria. Ministry gifts released even this year. Ministry gifts. Aramas de la Maronde. Kalaban de l'Este Piande. Rondos de Ka. Fresh fire. Mombres de Kia. Laman d'Alabas Toho. Jesus, Jesus, twice the anointing she's ever known. Supernatural strength this year. Loma Celebandri. Open doors you guys have never even imagined. Rama Celebaronde. He makes a way where there is no way. He goes before you and prepares every way. Father, we thank you. Every need supply. Every need supply. Every need supply. Celebaronde. Use her, Lord. Use her for your glory. Use her, Father, for your glory. Thank you, Father, for your anointing. Breaks every yoke. Fresh. Oil. Touch him, Lord. Fresh oil. Fresh. Fresh oil. Thank you, Father. Tap in. Tap in to a new vein. The Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, just worship. Just worship. Just worship. Sholama.
Rabba Salama. Fresh oil. Fresh fire. Holy Ghost. Jesus. It's everything.
Fire the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. Fresh. Fresh.
Fresh fire. The Holy Ghost.
Fresh fire. Fresh fire.
Holy Ghost.
fire, fire, fire. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire. Fresh.
Jesus.
Jesus. Fill him up. Hallelujah. Jesus. Fresh fire. Holy Ghost. Your seed, your seed, they're going to multiply spiritually. God's going to use your kids. Twice the anointing you've ever known. Oh yeah, many nations, many nations. Fresh oil, fresh fire, fresh fire. Kolababashe labaronde, sola mama mate te se. Colabas te parana marronde. Colabas te podede. Sombres te kelaba ase. Combres te kea. Sulemene. Colabas salamarene. Sondelere. Kabash ate sombreste. Twice the anointing I will ever know. Chrissy, you're going to carry that same anointing. You're going to carry that same anointing. It's yours. It's yours. Jesus. Fresh fire. More, more, more. Radasta.
The glory, all power, and dominion, all honor, all glory, all power. And dominion.
Woo! Woo!
Jesus.
Woo! Woo! Harababa salamaka te te te. Solamanamaka kwa debeste kena. Stombara dabia satata. If there was one scripture that I hold on to, Psalm 27, verse 4. It's the hallmark of who we are. It's the cry of our heart. We always go back to that one verse. One thing have I desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after. That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. To behold the beauty of the Lord.
Jesus. Yes, Father. Yes.
One thing you can't get away from when you live in His house. And that's the beauty of who He is. That beauty never fades. But that beauty is only enhanced. Why? They say that a bride is the most beautiful on her day of her wedding. But I'm here to disagree. After 40 years of marriage,
True.
My wife is more beautiful today than the day I married her. Why would I say that? Because I now know her. We've had 40 years to get to know one another. And every day, it's a fresh new journey. She reveals another part of herself to me that I didn't know. He's new every morning. Our relationship with Him is new every day. The beauty of the Lord, you can't behold it in a day. You can't take it in a day. It's a journey. It's a lifelong journey. And every day, He reveals another part of Himself to us. That's why we always have to come hungry. We always have to come thirsty. Lord, show me another facet of who You are. Reveal another part of Your personality. Another part of who You are to me. Lord, You're more beautiful to me today than the day I met You, than the day I was filled with the Holy Ghost, the day that I was healed, the day that I was redeemed. Every day, You show me another part of who You are. One thing I desire more than anything else, and that is to live in His presence all the days of my life. Tomorrow morning, I'm going to wake up in His presence. Tomorrow at lunch, I'm going to enjoy His presence. As the sun sets, I'm going to enjoy His presence. Tuesday morning, I'm going to arise to His presence. By noon, I'll be rejoicing in His presence. And as the sun sets, I'll rejoice in His presence. On Wednesday, I'll awaken to His presence. Every day, I want to live in His presence. To behold His beauty. Lord, open the eyes of our understanding that we might know Your will. Open our eyes that we might see Your beauty. We love You. We'll never stop. Can't live without You, Jesus. We love You, and we can't get enough. All this is for You, Jesus. We love You. We'll never stop. Can't live without You, Jesus. We love You, and we can get enough. All this is for You, Jesus. One last thing on my part. You came in struggling in your body. One thing I know about the presence of the Lord is when we enter into His presence, anything is possible. I can't tell you the number of times that I came in with pain in my body, and as I was worshiping and just moving through the service, because that's what I had to do in the natural realm, because I was required to, because I'd given a pastor or a church my word that I would be there, that as I was faithful to step in and do what I was called to do and allow that same anointing to touch my life as I was ministering, all the pain left. So my prayer is that as we've been laying hands and praying for people, that sickness, that pain, whatever that is, whatever you've been struggling, that it's gone. It's not here anymore. You're totally healed in Jesus' name. Is there anyone, you came in this place with pain in your body, but as we've been worshiping, that pain is gone. It's gone. It's gone. Where was the pain? It's gone, though. All over your, everywhere. And it's gone. Where was your pain? In your chest. It's gone. Anyone else, you came with pain. Came with pain. It's gone. Check. Check your body. Came in with pain, but it's gone. Receive it in your knees, in your ankles, your elbow, your back. In the anointing, when the waters trouble, do what you could not do. Do what you could not do. Receive your healing. Receive it. It's yours. The same anointing for financial breakthrough is here for healing. Restoration. To turn your blood, sugar diabetes, whatever it is, high blood pressure. Father, we come against those things right now in the name of Jesus. Your anointing is enough. Your power is enough. We take hold. We receive our healing right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We speak the name that's above every name, over every infirmity right now. Every attack in the physical realm, we rebuke it right now. It has to go. Has no right to hang around this place. Satan, move, leave. Let go. We curse. Every attack, pull it out by the root, has to go. We speak the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus right now. Over every body, every spirit of infirmity right now, in the name of Jesus. Totally healed. Totally healed. Right now, we receive it. We receive it right now. We receive it. Just tell him, say, Lord, I receive my healing right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Somebody rejoice. Somebody rejoice. Somebody rejoice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the presence of Jehovah, God Almighty, Prince of troubles vanish, hearts are mended in the presence of the In the prayer.
Father, we lay hold upon your promises. Father, we know that every one of your words are like silver tried in earthen vessels seven times. And Lord, we allow you and stand with you and agree with you that in this earthen vessel of our life, your word can be found and tried and purified and refined again until there is nothing within the framework of what we do and what we believe and what we say that is in any way out of agreement or out of alignment with that which you have ordained before anything existed. Your spoken word, that which you purposed. Lord, let your word be tried in me. Father, let your word, let every part of my being, let every part of my emotions, let every part of my decision, let every part of my thinking, let every part of my perception be completely conformed in every way to your word and to your thinking. Lord, that everything about our life stands certainly upon this solid rock. Hallelujah. This that is established forever. This that is established, this that is settled forever. This that cannot pass away. All flesh is as grass. And all the accomplishments and the glory and the abilities of men are as the flower of the field. The grass withers. And the flower thereof faileth. But your word endures forever. And let every part of my being, every part of my thinking. Lord, we thank you that you gave to us the mind of Christ. We have it.
It's ours.
We thank you that we have the mind of the Spirit.
Yeah.
Because we just agree with your word.
That's it.
We think like you described it. We act like you ordained it. As you spoken it, we walk it out. Father, I pray tonight in the name of Jesus that every person in this place will just recognize that you're making sure that as your word is forever settled in heaven, it is forever settled in our life. And that as we just absolutely sell out, no matter what happens, no matter what takes place, we find ourselves completely and 100% in agreement with you, praising you and worshiping you. I've discovered how to quickly, and I'm going to say it again, because I just hear the Lord saying it over and again. I have discovered how to quickly get out of whatever it is that seems to be outside of the realms of what God is doing, outside of the authority and the power that he's given, outside of the realms of having all that belongs to him, simply by worshiping him and praising him and thanking him for all that he's done and all that he's created and all that he's established. Hallelujah. I find myself complete in him. I find myself righteous as he's righteous, because he's my righteousness. I find myself holy even as he's holy, because he's my holiness. I find myself pure even as he's pure, because he's my purity. Isn't God so good?
Amen.
What is, everybody just stand up with me. And just, I want you to grab a hold of people around you and hug them, tell them that you love them and bless them in the name of Jesus. And I want you to live your life in a supernatural realm. I want you to boldly believe that which God has said this week in a way that goes beyond anything that you've ever believed or agreed with ever before, where you just step out. Sometimes people just lock that all into a realm of finances and they're always asking money for permission. I have chosen to refuse the realms of finances. Mm. I've chosen to disqualify money. Mm. I'm living a much more carefree life in the glorious sons of liberty. And I'm just doing what God said to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And just enjoying all that Hallelujah. He has empowered me with. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, listen, I want you to find everybody in this place and hug them. And tell them that you love them. Bless them. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me from the depths of poverty. Love lifted me. Love lifted me from the depths of sin and poverty. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore. Love it lifted me. He gave me a diamond ring, called me his. I got his name in the marriage. I got his fame living his life with you, Jesus. My master, Jesus, my Savior, love lifted me.